we have a camera here for the live stream.
Okay.
So if you want to come through that little gap there, quietly, you'll need to be there. But come in anywhere along here and be, you know, inconspicuous, then I'm happy for you to sort of, you know, be around this thing.
We can do that.
If you come too close, you're going to be right in some aspect of the
It's okay to hear for the minute.
Fine.
I'll move it away, obviously.
Yeah.
opportunity just to welcome you and to ask you if you would please respect our COVID restrictions that we have in place in this church. We must protect and keep safe everybody that uses this building. Confetti is acceptable, but please buy the ditch bait. Then it becomes a local authority problem and not mine. When our ceremony starts, I would ask you to please switch off your mobile phones, or at the very least, turn them to silent. And of course, this is an act of worship. So if I could ask you not to take photographs during the actual marriage service, because our videographer is going to be around, and if you start popping up taking pictures, Sandra's not going to be happy. And our last message is that you're going to be leaving through the door on my left. So just by where the red hymn books are, you won't go out of the door you came in. You'll go off to the side. The bridal party will be out of the main door, so you can run around if you're very quick and get some photographs of them. We don't make a collection during services in this church, particularly during COVID times, but of course, this building is beautiful and takes a lot of upkeep, and we do have a ministry to the people in this parish. So if you do feel able to make a donation as you leave, there is a box at the back and a very lovely photo of me next to the Taplow box. So it's a contact, you can't mistake us. There's a contactless card reader there, so yeah, you don't want us to be upset. Don't upset God. Here's some dosh. So that's also, but you will be asked to leave through that side door at the end of the service. But of course, you will enjoy our bridal party processing out, I'm sure, during the rehearsal. I was extremely pleased with the way they were going to process out, so I hope you will be too. That's it for me. We'll hand over to our lovely musicians again, and we'll let you know when the bride arrives.
Thank you.
on this very special day. And if I could now ask you to be upstanding for our bridal party. Nobody's playing for the bonus thing. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our bride. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. Welcome to the marriage blessing of Sandra and Geroge. Welcome to our church again today. I'd like to welcome also Rev Augustus Luke, who will be preaching for you. Let's hope it's not too long. Everything you need is in your service booklet. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. And so let us pray. God of wonder and and of joy. Grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We have come together in the presence of God to ask his blessing on the marriage of Geroge and Sandra and to share their joy. Our Lord Jesus Christ was himself a guest at a wedding in Cana of Galilee, and through his Spirit he is with us now. The Bible teaches us that marriage is a gift of God in creation and a means of his grace. A holy mystery in which man and woman become one flesh. It is God's purpose that, as husband and wife, give themselves to each other in love throughout their lives. They shall be united in that love as Christ is united with his church. Marriage is given that husband and wife may comfort and help each other, living faithfully together in need and in plenty, in sorrow and in joy. It is given that with delight and tenderness they may know each other in love, and through the joy of their bodily union, may strengthen the union of their hearts and lives. It is given as the foundation of family life, in which children may be born and nurtured in accordance with God's will, to his praise and glory. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life together in community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life created and hallowed by God that Geroge and Sandra have entered into. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this, their special day, we pray with them that, strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill the purpose of his whole life, or for their whole life together. Now I'm going to sing our hymn, which you'll have in your service sheets. It is Praise My Soul, the King of Heaven, which I gather is a very special hymn. For one special month. Your month.
Praise my soul, the King of heaven.
I'm now going to have our readings. So if I could ask Beatrice, Nantata and Amanda to come forward to the lectern to read their passage from 1 Corinthians.
From 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 8. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered, it keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails.
And now we invite George's nephew, Nicolas, to come and read from the letter to the Ephesians.
Ephesians chapter 4, verse 2 to 3. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Come down the middle, Leon. We just had a handover of babies. It's fine. Happens to us all. I hope there's just milk in that bottle.
Haven't you read, he replied, that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female, and said, for this reason a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and the two will become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate.
Amen. Now we're in for a treat. Sandra and George's pastor, Rev Augustus Luke, is going to preach for us.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Thank you so much for coming to be part of this amazing day. The flowers are so enormous, I can't see the bride and groom. I know you're there. And I just want to say, finally! Somebody say with me, finally!
Finally!
Sandra turned up! George was swaying and rocking and But she's here, George. And we are so glad that we can move forward. I must say, you know, Sandra, you look amazing. I want to hear you like you. But I ain't got none. But you look just amazing. And George, you just look an awesome groom. Is like my second daughter. I've known her from the age of 8 upwards. And I'm so happy for you today, as I'm sure your father Henry is. We're both very proud of you. George, you're an influential young man. I heard a lot of good things about you. And I pray on this day, this special day, that this ceremony will influence many young people into honoring their beautiful young ladies. Well, as you're about to start off on this open ocean called married life, I'd like to just encourage you along the way. You know, everybody has their opinion about marriage, because marriage is a different experience for everybody else, because you're all different. There is no official manual, I should say. It is simply the grace of God day by day. You are both unique individuals, and therefore, it's your expression of love to each other that will determine the outcome of your life together. Did you hear that? It's how you treat each other that's going to determine your outcome. God made life so that it could be enjoyed. According to the book of Genesis, God made Adam for a purpose. But Adam was incomplete. He didn't know what he was missing, but he knew he was missing something. God responded to Adam's incompleteness by creating an incredible woman, a copy of himself, but with a womb. That's why we say woman. Amen. So that he could be complete. You see, ladies, man is incomplete without you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Without your love, amen. Without your affection, without your wisdom.
Yeah.
Come on. You don't need to be Miss World, amen, to activate the emotions of a man. I'm going to say that again. Come on, you can look anyhow. But when a man sees you, he sees you. Well, this bridesmaid's in the front. Praise God. Amen. You see, God planned it so that two independent people, connected by the need of companionship, should live together in love. The saying goes like this. A man without a wife is like a kitchen without a knife. I let that one sink in, right?
Marinate.
Yo, if you ain't got where you're going to start looking. Because your life is incomplete without a wife. Amen. Not a girlfriend, a wife. All right, ladies, did you hear that? All you want a girlfriend, look for big wives. George, Proverbs 18:22 says, he that finds a true and faithful wife finds a good thing and obtains favor and approval from the Lord. Why does finding a good wife signify finding favor and approval from the Lord? It's because it takes wisdom to find such a wife, and wisdom comes from the Lord. Proverbs 31:10 says, a wife of a noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Amen. It's not easy to find a good wife. You need wisdom. Man, you can't look with your eyes, because you might not get the prize you're looking for. Amen. Hello, let's be real. Pretty face, something that don't know how to cook, ain't gonna make you happy. It's the truth.
And if you don't like quick meals like McDonald's and KFC, you need wisdom.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, praise God.
Amen.
Well, the wife of a noble character speaks with wisdom and gives faithful instruction, and she follows up her words with action. You see, Sandra, you just can't say it, you gotta do it. When you say something and your man hears you, he's registered that you are gonna do something. So if you don't do it, you let him down in a way. And so a wife with noble character brings good, not harm, to her husband. Always looking and covering him, and got his back, and not opening doors for anything to come into their life that is hurtful and damaging. She brings good, not harm. The children of a mother with a noble character will observe and will learn from her more about life, love, and service than from anyone else. Women, God made you to be the crown and glory of your man. That means you have the right to a place, not behind him or in front of him, but a place alongside him as his life's companion. Not behind him. Somebody say, a good man always has a good woman behind him. A good man has a good woman beside him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Don't mean you women run out in front. It means step it back and walk it step in step, so that you're seen together as one. Amen.
Amen.
Likewise, women, hallelujah. God made women and gave her to the man. He did not give man the job of programming the woman to be seen and not heard. I heard that one. You're not meant to be quiet. You're meant to speak with wisdom. You're meant to influence the hearts. Amen. With integrity and virtue. The man does not have a right to tell you shut up. Amen. Because you have wisdom. Amen.
Amen.
All right. So likewise, when you were given to the man not to live independently of him, but you have to allow him to influence and to lead you. Oh, he didn't say amen to that one.
Amen.
Yeah, you're not an independent person. When you're in a marriage, there is a unity and a fellowship, and the man has an ability to influence and lead you, because you make a complete unity together. How am I doing for time? Okay, all right.
3 minutes.
Oh, my goodness. How he was not made to manipulate with you. Were not. Come on, the man was not made for you to manipulate him with those soft eyes and the soft words. Amen?
Amen.
Come on. He was there for you to live and move in a partnership. God brought the man and the woman together so that through their ability to communicate with each other, they would enrich and empower each other to be the best that they can be. So, George, you're going to bring the best out of Sandra. Sandra, you're going to bring the best out of George. Amen?
Amen.
That's what you're doing today. You're going to start a journey of reforming each other. Amen?
Amen?
So you bring the best out of each other. Therefore, the wisdom of the woman is as valid as the wisdom of the man in the marriage relationship. And it's important that there is humility and vulnerability in their relationship, especially when it comes to disputes. Hello. It will not always be sunny skies and gentle breezes. There will be cloudy days. There'll be days when you will feel a little bit upset because he has not said, darling, I love you. Oh, he may have not done what you want him to do. And it's in those times, I must say, after 35 years of married life, I will say, it's especially important that in them times, humility and vulnerability is demonstrated in your marriage. That you give in and listen, that you don't come to a conclusion before you've already heard the full story.
that you be patient with one another, that you forgive one another, somebody, that you quickly mend any broken fences so that the devil does not build a house in your relationship. A foolish man is the one who does not draw from the wisdom of his wife. In life, we'll have many relationships, but the marriage relationship is the deepest rational commitment we can ever make. Its value demands a level of sacrifice that calls for total surrender of all ourselves to each other, even to the point that if you need to stand in the way of harm for your wife, you will. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
You see, when I know these two guys. They love each other.
Amen.
I'm telling you, they love each other. We're sitting down doing some marriage counseling together, and I say, my goodness, it's good to see two young people so in love with each other. But if that love is threatened, you've got to do your best to come against it, George, because your love is sacrificial. Amen?
Amen?
It means you seek the highest good for Sandra and that you're surrounded with your caring, unselfish love. We must be willing to give up and to stay away from anything that will prevent you from giving Sandra that sacrificial love. Amen? I said in the beginning, you're a young man with a profile. And I'm sure there'll be many young ladies looking at you. I can't see Sandra's face right now. But I can guess what it's looking like. Yeah. They can look because he's a handsome guy. Almost as handsome as three. But the problem is that if you look back too hard, you open the door. Amen. Same goes for you, Sandra. You're a beautiful queen.
Amen.
Amen. And I know some men want to beep you. But just walk as if you don't hear it.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because you're going to give up anything that's going to come and interfere with this relationship. Amen?
Amen.
A man is to love his wife as he loves his own body. Real love does not seek to use the other party as a home help, providing a service. Amen. This is getting serious now. Any love that drags a person down is not love. I'll say that again. Any love that abuses somebody, it ain't love. Any man that regards his wife consciously or subconsciously as simply someone who cooks, washes his clothes, and cleans her house and looks after the children, they need to be dropped up over at Mars or the moon or some far place. Because the time for that is past. I don't care what country you belong to. You love, you respect one another. Amen. We're not slaves to each other.
Amen.
Love brought us together and love will keep us together.
Amen.
Amen. It's not about ensuring your physical comforts are attended to as and when you wish. It's about cherishing the one you love. Always doing the best you can to love and protect that which is important to you both. Love acts out of regard for the other person. And love burns out the impurities and the deceits that we bring into marriage. Love burns it all out. For the sake of this love, a man must leave his father and his mother. He must separate himself from any other commitment to family and friends that would rob his wife of the service due to her. Today, father gave the daughter and the son received the wife. They left home. They've left home somewhere. When you know why I got married, my wife got onto the phone. She's debunked. She got on the phone, you know, because maybe I wasn't doing what I was supposed to. She got on the phone and said, "He's not helping me to wash up." She said, "He's yours. Train him." Amen. You've left home, George.
I want to look at you now for that.
You've left home. Sandra, you've left home. You are big people now. Amen?
Amen.
They're not responsible for you. You can get advice from them, but it's up to you too to make a life together. Because you've left the nest, as it were. You've grown up, and you now have responsibility. Amen? I'm going to hide away again. I'm finished, almost. Temptation is a constant presence throughout all our lives. That desire to do something, especially something that is wrong and or unwise. In your married life, temptation takes a new destructive power because it will rob you of everything that is valuable in your lives. Proverbs 9:17 says, to those who have no sense. This is the Solomon writing about people who don't use wisdom, who do the wrong things. He said, stolen water is sweet. Food eaten in secret is delicious. But at the end, it brings death. You may enjoy that secret piece of extramarital, but it's death at the end. You lose everything. So, know what is important to you. Sandra and George, as I close, you will not encounter any temptation, regardless of its source, that is not common to human experience. Any temptation you will face in your married life is not unusual or beyond your ability to resist. But this is what the scripture says in 2 Thessalonians 3:3. But the Lord is faithful. And he will strengthen you, setting you on a firm foundation, and he will protect and guard you from the evil one. Your whole marriage relationship is in the Lord. In the Christian home you are going to build together, you need to include Jesus. Yeah, that name. That name that is above every name. That name to which every knee will bow and every tongue confess that he is Lord in heaven and earth and beneath. Don't leave him out, because he has all power and all authority, and he can order your steps. Although you may not see him, he's always your unseen guest. Welcome him by living in a loving relationship that reflects his sacrificial love for his bride, the church. And as someone said to me, don't allow any locked rooms in your marriage that Jesus cannot enter. Because in the Christian marriage, there is not two partners, but three. The third is Jesus Christ. God bless you and make a lot of success.
George and Sandra, the vows you are about to take are made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. George Dowdy, having taken Sandra Diana to be your wife, will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? Sandra Diana, having taken George Dowdy to be your husband, will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
give Sandra Diana.
To give Sandra Diana.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
I, Sandra Diana.
I, Sandra Diana.
Took you, George Dowling.
Took you, George Dowling.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Till death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
In the presence of God I make this vow.
Now I'm going to invite George and Sandra to make their personal vows to each other.
Sandra, I vow to love you with my actions, according to God's law. I will love you with the attention I pay and the things I say. I pledge my mind, my body, and my soul to our union before God. And I give you my word that no one will ever come between us. I promise to listen to you. Your words are precious to me. They have led me to my best self, and I will never lose sight of that. This love was born in honesty, so I will forever be transparent with you. I vow to be your safe place. You are God's ultimate gift to me, and I will guard this blessing with my life. I vow to always protect you, uplift you, and honor you. In the book of eternity, our names are written next to each other. This has always been true, but now, on this day, we announce it to the world. I vow to love you, not just for the wedding, not just when it's easy, but for eternity. We are forever.
My personal communion, my friend, and more. I vow to be a wife that makes you proud. I vow to continue to grow with you, and I vow to protect our commitment to one another. I promise to love you. I promise to cook you my toke. Stand by you no matter what, and support you as you strive to achieve your goals. George, you are and always will be my soulmate, the love of my life, and my best friend. I love you.
Nathan, your big moment has arrived. I think you might have to come in on this side. Mind the trunk. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to George and Sandra a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
George Dowdy, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
That's charming. In the presence of God and before this congregation, George Dowdy and Sandra Diana have made vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore proclaim that before God, you are now husband and wife.
That they will walk continually in your blessing and in your favor.
I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that there the womb will bring forth good fruit.
Amen.
I pray, God, that will be boys and girls with outstanding character. I pray you give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And I pray they will be perfectly formed so that your image will be seen in them. Father, I pray for George and Sandra that they will be in good health. That, Lord, no enemy will waylay them in any way. That, Lord, you'll make a way of escape for them from evil and evil that they don't know or see. I pray, God, that you will bless them with their finances. I pray, God, no devourer will come and take away that which they work for. No stricter or trickster will rob them of their goodness. Father, bless them, I pray. And the people that come into their life, I pray, you'll give them eyes to see and ears to hear and hearts to understand the kind of relationships that they need to have with these people. Bless them with your grace. Bless them with your favor. Let your goodness continue to sustain them all the days of their life. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Faithful God, holy and eternal, source of life and spring of life, we thank and praise you for bringing George and Sandra together, and we pray for them. May their marriage be life-giving and life-long, enriched by your presence and strengthened by your grace. May they bring comfort and confidence to each other in faithfulness and trust. May the hospitality of their home bring refreshment and joy to all around them. May their love overflow to neighbours in need and embrace those in distress. May they discern in your word order and purpose for their lives. And may the power of your Holy Spirit lead them in truth and defend them in adversity. May friends and family gathered here and those separated by distance be strengthened and blessed this day. May they nurture their family with devotion, see their children grow in body, mind, and spirit, and come at last to the end of their lives with hearts content and in joyful anticipation of heaven. Amen.
Amen.
So we join together in the prayer our Saviour himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace, and the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and all whom you love and pray for, today and always.